Africa as one of the poorest regions in the world, despite being rich in natural resources such as diamonds, gold, and oil, most African countries are still among the least developed regions in the world. According to statistics from the World Bank, about 43% of the African population lives below the extreme poverty line of $1.25 per day. A whopping 33 of the world's poorest countries are in Africa. However, the challenges facing Africa are not just economic. Infrastructure shortages, especially in the energy sector, have significantly hampered the continent's development. Under this circumstance, Western developed countries began to join the ranks of supporting Africa. Some countries choose to exploit Africa's rich mineral resources, while others help Africa through various cooperation projects. It is particularly worth mentioning that China's One Belt, One Road initiative has brought significant changes to many African countries. But China's involvement is not limited to infrastructure construction, but also covers investments in major energy projects. In 2023, China announced the launch of a large-scale power generation project in Africa. Its annual power generation capacity is expected to be as high as 300 million kilowatt hours, enough to supply the electricity needs of 420,000 households. Today, we will discuss this huge power station project. If you like our video content, please click to subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you can receive all our latest video content. Now, let's get into today's topic. South Africa, as one of Africa's economic giants, has experienced years of rapid development and its population has exceeded 59.894 million. This rapid population growth, coupled with a booming industrial sector, has made South Africa one of the richest countries in Africa. However, any rapid development is inseparable from sufficient power support. Unfortunately, South Africa has been facing severe power shortages over the past few years, which directly led to the country's industrial and mining growth stalling in 2020. As far as I know, electricity production in South Africa is mainly handled by the national power company Eskom. Although Eskom operates about 30 power plants using different forms of energy, it is noteworthy that about 80% of its electricity supply relies on 15 coal-fired power stations. Most of these power stations were built before 1990. Not only are they inefficient, but they also frequently experience breakdowns and shutdowns, seriously affecting South Africa's power supply. According to statistics, South Africa suffers from power outages for more than half of the 365 days a year, and the average power supply is only about 8 hours a day. This situation has seriously affected the daily lives of most people, making it difficult to maintain normal operations. In February 2023, South African President Cyril Ramaphosa announced worrying news South Africa officially entered a power outage disaster state. This news clearly shows that the power shortage problem faced by South Africa has reached serious proportions. As an important partner of African countries, China will naturally not stay away from South Africa's power shortage issue. In June 2023, the President of South Africa paid a state visit to China, during which the two sides reached important consensus on cooperation. Then, on July 26, 2023, South Africa and China signed a major cooperation agreement with a total value of $370 million to jointly promote a grand photovoltaic power generation project. This project is named Damrat Photovoltaic Power Station, and it is the largest ground-level photovoltaic power station project signed by China in South Africa to date. According to the cooperation plan between the two parties, the Damrat Photovoltaic Power Station is located in the Sasolburg area of the Free State Province of South Africa. The project relies heavily on sunlight to provide large amounts of clean and renewable electricity. In addition to the participation of Chinese companies, Mainstream, a well-known developer from Ireland, has also joined the construction of this project. It is expected that once the project is fully completed and put into operation, it will deliver up to 300 million kilowatt hours of clean electricity to the South African national grid every year, which is enough to meet the annual electricity needs of approximately 420,000 South. In the construction of the Damrat photovoltaic power station, Chinese engineers incorporated a number of innovative design elements. Among them, the power station uses a large-scale photovoltaic panel array. These high-efficiency photovoltaic panels are designed to maximize the capture and conversion of solar energy. The panels were arranged with topographic features and sun angles in mind, aiming to optimize energy absorption and conversion efficiency. In addition, taking into account the impact of the project on the local ecological environment, the layout of these photovoltaic panels has been specially planned to minimize damage to local wildlife habitats. At the same time, the power station is also equipped with an advanced energy management system that can monitor and adjust the generation, storage, and distribution of electricity in real time to ensure the continuity and efficiency of energy supply. Taking into account the climate characteristics of South Africa, the Damrat photovoltaic power station paid special attention to adapting to South Africa's geographical and climatic conditions in the selection of construction materials. Therefore, this project selected a new type of concrete that is resistant to corrosion and high temperature to ensure the stability of the power station and the durability of the equipment in the long-term operation in the future. The application of this material not only reflects the cutting-edge level of modern photovoltaic technology, but also reflects China's rigor and focus in building this photovoltaic power station for South Africa. For South Africa, this photovoltaic power station project is not only an important support point for the current power crisis, but also the hope for gradually solving the national energy problem and promoting comprehensive regional economic and social progress in the future. In addition, China also plans to provide up to 66 gigawatts of solar energy infrastructure to South Africa and share relevant technical knowledge free of charge. Currently, project work is focused on developing renewable energy generation and energy storage technologies to reduce greenhouse gas emissions from fossil fuel use, thereby helping South Africa achieve its renewable energy use and emissions reduction goals. The construction of the Damrat photovoltaic power station is also expected to drive investment and development in multiple local industries. In fact, South Africa, as one of the best photovoltaic power generation project development sites in the world, has abundant photovoltaic resources, especially in the Northwest and Northern Cape regions, which have abundant sunlight resources and are very suitable for the development of photovoltaic power generation projects. Whether it is China or other countries, most countries maintain good cooperative relations with South Africa. I believe that with the joint efforts of all countries in the world, South Africa will gradually get rid of the dilemma of power shortage in the future and bring a better life to the local people.